You're not going to have to worry about better job. Amen. Because God blesses his people. Can I get a witness in this house? He bless you going out. He bless you coming in. Can I get a witness in this house? Tell your neighbor, say, stop the worry. Stop the worry. God is still in charge. Amen. I know they said charge and Charles in charge, but God is in charge. Can I get a witness right here? Internal fear. Fear, worry, fear. Amen. Praise God, will keep you in bondage. Amen. Worry and fear. All through scriptures, when the angel came to Mary, the first thing he told Mary said, fear not. Amen. That's the first thing. Amen. Anytime the enemy comes in, he brings fear. Amen. You go to the doctor and the doctor says something to you. Praise God. And he says, you know, you got this thing. Right away, fear grabs you. Amen. You begin to look up how many people died from this disease. Amen. You begin to feel that I think I'm going out. Praise God. How did it? But tell your neighbor, say, you can't go nowhere if God ain't calling you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. You got to tell yourself. Tell your neighbors. You got to tell yourself, I am a fighter and I am a winner. God don't have no losers. I said, God don't have no losers. Tell your neighbor, say, you are a winner. I am too. Stop acting like letting that enemy treat you like a ping pong ball. Amen. Bouncing you around. Praise God. You got to get a hold of the word of God. Amen. So there's eternal fear that sets in. There's worry. Praise God. Hallelujah. And then we get to the place. Praise God. Hallelujah. That we just don't want to move out. I found people, they don't want to stay in the same old, same old. How many know you get tired of being the same old thing all the time? I get tired of eating the same old food. Chicken. Praise God. Hallelujah. The other day, I went and bought me some pork chops. I said, you know, I'm tired of this chicken. Praise God. I ain't ate a pork chop in over a year. Amen. But I said, you know what? I'm tired of chicken. Chicken. Where you go? I got a chicken. The cheapest food you can get is a chicken. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes you got to dress it up a little bit. Give me some smothered something. Smothered chops or looking at making some of y'all hungry right now. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometime you got to dress it up a little bit. Praise God. God has a variety. Can I get a witness in here? Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Once we get stuck on the same old, all I do is eat. I go to church and that's it. Eat, go to church, use the bathroom. Eat, go to church, use the bathroom. Well, dress it up a little bit. Come on, take a jog, take a walk. Praise God. Can I get a witness in here? Praise God. Hallelujah. Go and visit somebody. Tell somebody that God is good. Hallelujah. Amen. So many people are in bondage. They keep themselves in bondage. But today you coming out. Tell your neighbor, say, you coming out. You coming out today. All right. There's internal bondage. Then there is external bondage. Praise God. External bondage. That's just, amen, fourth chapter of that same book. The Bible says, and Moses said, answered and said, but suppose they would not believe me or listen to my voice. I go down there to Pharaoh, he's not going to listen to me. Amen. They start worrying about people. Don't you know people can keep you in bondage? People can hold you back. People, praise God, hallelujah, amen, can be very detrimental to you, especially if you don't have the right people around you. You got to surround yourself with positive-minded people. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness in here? You got to surround yourself with people to tell you, you can do it. You can make it. Praise God. Hallelujah. You surround yourself with a bunch of negative people, you'll stay in the same rut over and over again. Praise God. This time next year, praise God, you'll be in the same old position. Ain't going nowhere, ain't done anything. Praise God, because people tell you that you can't do it. Don't you know, praise God, when people tell you can't do it, God says you can. Amen. Because I read in the scriptures, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Praise God. Just tell your neighbor, say, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. I can. Moses, stop worrying about the people. Oh, my, my, my. And that's our trouble today. You let somebody speak into you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Muhammad Ali, amen, was in, I forget, he was in elementary school or whatever. Praise God. And while he was sitting there at the desk, he began to draw, amen, himself fighting in the ring. Amen. And then above that capture of his drawing, he says, I am the greatest. Amen. The teacher saw that. Praise God. And the teacher rebuked him for it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. And said some negative stuff to him. Amen. But look at this. He became one of the greatest fighters. Praise God. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't you tell me what God cannot do. Amen. Albert Einstein, praise God, couldn't have a talk. Praise God. Hallelujah. Couldn't even hardly put a sentence together. Praise God. But look. Amen. He came one of the brilliant minds that it is. Amen. It was in the world. Amen. Praise God. Why? Because he persevered. Amen. He did not give up. Praise God. Hallelujah. He kept on pushing. Tell your neighbor, say, keep on pushing. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't you let nobody speak into you and tell you, praise God, it can't be done. Don't tell them that you can't write a book. Praise God, hallelujah. I ain't barely finished out of high school, but I got my first book out. Praise God, hallelujah. Amen. It encouraged me, praise God, to let me know, amen, that God can take a nobody and make them somebody. God can take, amen, your shortcomings, and he can take it around and dress it up, praise God, and fix it for you. Why? Because I believe what the word of God says. Can I get a witness in this house? Praise God. People will keep you in bondage. And go over to Genesis, the 12th chapter. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Places, amen, will keep you into bondage. Praise God. Because the enemy knows, praise God, hallelujah, that if I can just keep them in bondage, then they will not, amen, go forth in the name of Jesus. They will not, amen, be able to do what God would have them to do. But I got news for the enemy this morning. We're all coming out today. Praise God. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, say, no more bondage. Say, I'm free. Amen. And who the Son set free is free indeed. Are y'all still there? Praise God. Hallelujah. Because we serve a God, amen, that is able to bring us out every time. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Genesis 12 and 1. And the Lord said unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, saying, this month shall be your beginning of the month, and it shall be the first month of the year for you. Speak to all the congregation of Israel, saying, praise God, one-tenth of the month every man shall take for him a lamb. Amen. They were so free that they came and they offered up to God and they made sacrifices unto God. Praise God. And God, amen, began to deliver them because they followed the examples of what God wanted them to do. Amen. They was free, amen, of allowing the enemy to keep them, amen, surrounded, amen, in bondage. Amen. He had them to go forth in the name of Jesus. So sometimes the places that we are at, amen, can cause us to be in bondage. He told, praise God, hallelujah, Abram says, listen, I want you to get out from your country, get out from among your family, praise God, because I'm going to bless you, praise God. As long as he stayed in that particular place, God was not able to bless him. Tell your neighbor, says, sometimes you got to leave out of the place where you are. Praise God. In order for God to bless you, he says, I'm going to bless you and I'm going to show you a land, praise God, that's going to be flowing with milk and honey. Because sometimes places can keep us in bondage. A lot of times we're in bondage because we won't even come to the house of prayer. In Hebrews 10 and 25, it says, forsake not the gathering of yourselves together as believers. Praise God. Hallelujah. So what the enemy does, he keeps us away from God's house. Praise God. And that's the very place where God wants to bless you at. Can I get a witness in here? Praise God. Also, another bondage, amen, that keeps us, amen, in bondage is our money. Amen. In 1 Timothy 6 and 10, it says the love of money is the root of all evil. Praise God. Hallelujah. Your money can keep you into bondage. Why? Amen. Because we don't do with our money what we're supposed to be doing. Every year I get, amen, the statements I got to fill out and I got to sign the statements, and y'all should be getting them today, of how much money and tithes the people pay in church. Some of y'all doing better. Amen. Some of y'all slacked up and some of y'all ain't doing nothing. Lord have mercy. I know who you are. Praise God. Hallelujah. I know who you are. Some of y'all have gotten better. But I'm wondering about some people, how they think the church is going to run. The church, this church here, praise God, amen, was founded upon tithes and offering. Amen. The very seat you sitting in is because of tithes and offering. The very building that you are in is because of tithes and offering. Praise God, how do you, these microphones, amen, is tithes and offering. These chairs, tithes and offering. The rug, tithes and offering. Everywhere you look come from tithes and offering. Tell your neighbor, say, where are you now with your tithes and offering? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. How is the church supposed to run? Is the church supposed to run off? Hallelujah. When the bill come in, praise God, you send the bill back and put a note in there and say, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And come into church, the lights wouldn't be on. Amen. But I thank God. The Bible said the love of money. The love of money is the root of all evil. It didn't say money now, but the love of it. You got to be free. You got to be able to, amen, give God what belongs to him. Tell your neighbor, say, give God what belongs to him. Praise God. Hallelujah. Give him the 10%, amen, of your income. Amen. Give it to him and give it. Amen. God loves a mad giver. Amen. God loves a cheerful giver. When that time to come for the offering, amen, get real happy. Amen. Get real happy, because the Lord says, listen, when you bring your tithe and your offering, he's going to open up the windows of heaven. Lord, I wish I had some saints in here. He's going to open up the windows of heaven. The windows can't open until God says, come on, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. Praise God. And I'm going to bless you, bless you, bless you, bless you. Amen. Come on, give me, praise God, what belongs to me. Give me the first fruit of your increase. Amen. Come and bring it to me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't hold back. Praise God. Don't be stingy with God. Because when you get stingy with God, praise God, we get stingy. God gets stingy with us. God says, I want your time. Praise God. How do you take out some time? Praise God, along with your money, to give God some praise. We see some of the saints about once a month. Amen. We see some saints at Easter. Amen. Come on now. Praise God. And at Christmas time. Amen. Easter, we get our bunny rabbits. We get our eggs. Praise God. And we all get happy at Easter. But tell your neighbor, say, every day is Easter with me. Hallelujah. He woke me up this morning. Amen. I got to give him a praise. Amen. He brought me out. I got to give him a praise. Praise God. Hallelujah. Bondage. Money can be a bondage. The place you at can be a bondage. Amen. Tell your neighbor, say, people, places, and things can be a bondage. Amen. Praise God. The people can be a bondage. Amen. The places can be a bondage. Praise God. And the things, let me deal with the things. Amen. Things can get a hold of people today. Drugs can be a bondage. Praise God. How many used to be drug? Amen. Use drugs in here. Come on now. Don't be scared of nobody. Praise God. Look at that. That's one hand over there. Are you delivered? Praise God. Someone stand up and give God a praise for this young lady being delivered. I don't care what. Come on now. Praise God. I don't care what you say. God can deliver you from drugs. Can I get a witness in here? Well, I just can't let this go, you know. Praise God, it's just a part of me, you know. praise God, it's just a habit I got, amen, and I just can't let it go. But I found out, praise God, hallelujah, if you want God, amen, more than you have that particular, that drug there, if it exceeds, amen, praise God, that drug calling you, amen, and begin to go to God and says, Lord, listen, I just can't handle it no more. I need to give it over to you. And you know what the Bible says? Cast all. Are y'all still with me in here? Tell your neighbor, say, don't give it to me because I can't help you. Praise God. He said, but cast all your cares. Amen. Upon who? Praise God. Who you going to give it to? Praise God. Sometimes you got to wrestle. Amen. There was a young lady. She was on, amen, crack cocaine. When crack, amen, came out. Amen. And the crack began to make people so addicted. Amen. And this young lady had, amen, had got involved. Praise God. And started smoking that crack. Amen. Praise God. And she came to me and said, listen, I need to be delivered. Amen. Amen. From this cocaine demon, this crack demon. Amen. Because there ain't nothing but demons. Amen. That ride on you and sit on you and try to keep you in bondage. Praise God. She said, just lock me in church. Amen. Praise God. I want to go and I want to get locked in church. And I want to give this thing over to God. Amen. I locked up in the church. Amen. All night long. Praise God. Hallelujah. And she stayed in church wrestling with that demon. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. She was there wrestling. She gave it over to the Lord. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, say, when you give it over to the Lord, he'll work it out. Can I get a witness in here? Praise God. Y'all trying to figure out who it is. God bless. Some of y'all saints here, y'all. Somebody trying to figure out who it is. Lord, help this place. Praise God. All I know is God is a delivering God. Hallelujah. God, say, stand there and wrestle with that demon. Praise God. Wrestle with that demon. Praise God. When she came out, praise God, she said, I got the victory. And far as I know, ain't went back to it yet. Can I get a witness in here? Tell your neighbor, say, you don't have to let the devil hold you in bondage. You can break free. Hallelujah. I don't care what it is. Who the Son set free is free indeed. You can break free from that drug. It ain't nothing but a plant, no way. Can I get a witness in here? Tell your neighbor, say, don't let no plant hold you in bondage. Hallelujah. Don't you let no grass, amen, hold you in bondage. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't you let no grape hold you in bondage. That's all it is, grass, grapes. Praise God. And you're going to let some plant hold you in bondage? Amen. When God, amen, has given us power, amen, to overcome, amen, every drug. Can I get a witness in this house? Hallelujah. I don't care where you come from. God can do it. Give God a praise in here. Some years ago, we had a revival in this church, and I think it was a whole week. Back then, we used to go for whole weeks, not 3 days. Amen. You can't do a whole week now. They get tired now. They get worn out now. Oh, man, we used to stay in the service till 12, 11 o'clock at night. Come to church at, amen, 8 in the morning. Amen. Didn't get home till 12 o'clock. Some of that happened to some of us. We'll pass out. Praise God. Some of y'all pass out just thinking about it. Praise God. Hallelujah. But we had revival a whole week. Had the revivalist in here. Had Bishop Fred Sanders was here. And he ran a revival. He was just preaching. You got saved. And then one of them, amen, some of you, I don't know, was that years ago. Praise God. But this was the time that we had the revival. And a man came into church. And he was sloppy drunk. Oh, my God. And the ushers began to back away, you know. Praise God. Hallelujah. This man, he's smelling. He's thinking. Praise God. Hallelujah. Pastor, what we going to do? I said, ain't nothing that we can do. Let him lay back there. Praise God. He laid on back there. Amen. Drunk as Cooter Brown. Praise God. Hallelujah. My God, he was smelling up a storm. Amen. But don't you know God is looking for those type of people? Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He came the first night. He was all drunk up. Praise God. Hallelujah. And then he came back the next night. Amen. But he's a little bit more sober. Praise God. Hallelujah. Then he came back the next night. Tell your neighbor, say, keep on coming. Keep on coming. Praise God. Don't y'all stop. Keep on coming. If it don't happen one time, keep on coming. Kept on coming. when the time for the altar call came, he was sober enough to come down to the altar. Lord, I want to be saved. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody give him a praise. We baptize him in the name of Jesus. That's why every church need a pool. I wouldn't have a church that didn't have a pool. The first time we had the church, I called, I said, I need a pool. Always had a pool. Why? Because when people want to be saved, I'll dump you in the water in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible said, whosoever believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Can I get a witness in here? We baptized him that night. We didn't wait till Sunday. We want to make sure that demon get off of him. We took him now in the name of Jesus. Guess what? Come to find out, this man here used to be one of the top professional carpenters. Praise God, he could build anything with his hands. Amen. And he got sober enough that he came, he built the bathroom back there. Amen. For the women. Hallelujah. He built the front door for the church. Praise God. Hallelujah. Then I said, hey, man, don't stop there. Praise God. Went over to my house and built me a little garage over to my house. Praise God. Hallelujah. After a while, him and his wife, because he had separated from his wife because he was so full of drugs, so full of drinking. Praise God. Hallelujah. But him and his wife got back together. Somebody give God a praise in the house of God. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, so don't tell me what God can't do. If he did it for one, he'll do it for you. Amen. Because he's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you can even ask or think. Can I get a witness in this house? That was a good praise right there, son. Hallelujah. That was a good Don. Praise God. Let's try. Praise God. Tell your neighbor, say, God can do anything. I said, God can do anything. Now ask your neighbor a question. Say, is there anything too hard for God? Somebody give him a praise. Thank you. I'm coming in now. Sometimes bondages of things, people, places, and things. Sometimes your boyfriend, girls, can be a bondage. Are y'all still, y'all getting quiet on me now? Amen. You want to go to church, and he want to go to the nightclub. Come on, baby, come on, we're going to go hang out tonight. No, you said, come on, let's go hang out in the house of God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's go hang out in the house of God. It can be a bondage. Your girlfriend can be a bondage. Things can be a bondage to you. You're trying to serve God. And matter of fact, you ought to start changing your friendships. Can I get a witness in here? Oh, touch your nail. I'm going to get in trouble now. See, y'all was with me before, but I'm messing up now. The Bible said, touch not, taste not, and handle not the unclean thing. Hallelujah. The first thing we go do, we go touch the unclean stuff. We go pick stuff that don't belong to us. Can I get a witness in here? I know he look good, but he ain't clean. Praise God. Hallelujah. I know he, my God, look at him. He looks so wonderful. Everything look good ain't good. Tell your neighbors, everything that glitter ain't gold. Amen. It's fool's gold. You got a lot of fool golds out here now. It looks good. It sounds good. It talks good. But my God, when you get it home, it can be Dracula. Can I get a witness in here? Be careful. Praise God. Hallelujah. What you let into your house. Tell your neighbor, say, touch not, taste not, handle not the unclean thing, because it'll mess you up. Can I get a witness here? I got to come. People can get you in bondage. Places can get you in bondage. Things can get you in bondage. And some saints now, they're going to pick up these things. Some people got these little Buddha statues now. And when they first get in the house, they rub Buddha's thumb. Lord have mercy, Jesus. Somebody said, Lord have mercy. Tell your neighbor, say, you don't need Buddha. You need Jesus. Can I get a witness in here? I ain't bound down to no statue. Oh, it's all right because, you know, it means that he says this and says this and says that. Everything that talking ain't talking right. Praise God. And some of the stuff, let me ask you a question and I'm going to hurry up. Amen. Hurry up and sit down. How much poison does it take to kill you? A whole lot or just a little bit? Praise God. How do you can take a truth and put a little bit of untruth in there, but it's all a lie. Can I get a witness in right now? Praise God. Hallelujah. The Bible says neither is there salvation in any other name but by the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, you know, there's so many ways to get to heaven. You know, there's so many roads to get to heaven. But tell your neighbors, it ain't but one way. Amen. Jesus said, I am the way. Mm-hmm. I am the truth and I am the life. Can I get a witness in here? And there is a narrow way and there is a broad way. The Bible said the broad way leadeth to destruction, but there's a narrow way. Tell your neighbor, say it might be narrow, but I'm going to get on in God's way. Hallelujah. So people, places, and things. And keep you in bondage. Hallelujah. Are y'all there? The Bible says the devil is, I'm coming in as accuser of the brethren. He accuses you day and night. The Bible says he's a liar. And he accuses you and he comes to keep you in bondage. But tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I am a child of God. And I am free. I'm free from foolishness. I'm free from pride. I'm free from things. I'm free from people. I'm free from things. Somebody give God a praise in this house. Somebody give him a praise in this house. Hallelujah. 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 I'm coming in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, breaking free from the bondages of Satan. I don't know what's going on in your individual life or what you have to face with, but I can tell you this much. God is our Savior, and he don't want you in bondage. Just tell your neighbor, say, the enemy is a liar. God don't want you to listen to obey and follow the dictates of the enemy. I am free to give God praise. I am free to give him glory. Can I get a witness in here? I said, can I get a witness in here? Hallelujah. Oh God. Everybody standing as I get ready to come in. As we celebrate the Black History Month, and you look around and see all these great black people that have served, freedom ain't free. It's going to cost you something to be free. It costs you a sacrifice. We have people on this board who have died for freedom. Martin Luther King Jr. came to New York and was stabbed. They stabbed him. A woman stabbed him when he came. But Dr. King overcame that stab wound. They said if it had been one other little inch closer to his heart, he would have been killed. I satated a becosa. Rosa Parks, my God, she got tired. She was on the bus and she would get on the bus and have to go to the back of the bus because she couldn't sit up front. But this day she says, I'm tired. You know, when you get ready to get, you got to get tired of being in bondage. She sat up there on the front like she owned the place. Hallelujah. Came and they locked her up. But they all got together and they boycotted the buses. Said, we ain't gonna ride no bus until we can sit where we wanna. Hallelujah. And they did it for a whole year, boycotted. They pulled together, drove in their cars, they walked. They did some of everything to get to that place. Do you know when you hit the man and his money? Oh, my. If you want to stop, hit him in his money. After a year later, amen, the law came out. You can sit anywhere on the bus you want to sit. Tell your neighbor, say, you don't have to go in the back no more. Y'all. Some of y'all sit in the back because you don't want to come up and give God prayer. You can come on up front now. Tell your neighbor, say, today is your day to be able to give God praise. Anybody free today? Anybody free today? Why don't y'all give him a free praise? Why don't you give him a free praise? Sometimes we pick up things and we think that it's always going to be like this. But if you give it to Jesus, it will work out. This morning, we want to pray for everybody that maybe have picked up something, or whatever, that might have you in bondage. It may not be drugs. It may not be alcohol. It could be low self-esteem. It could be a number of things that can hold you in bondage. And whatever it might be this morning, I want you to give it to God. Because God is here to give you your deliverance. Can I get a witness in here? Drugs, alcohol, all that stuff had me bound. I couldn't wait till weekend to come. Couldn't wait till the weekend to come so I could do my thing. I worked. I went forth and I worked. And I used to drive a school bus some years ago. And I used to drive going to trade school. And I went around and picked up people. And on Friday, I'd buy me a case of wine. I mean, not one bottle, but a case. And I had a special store that I get it from. And that Friday, had a case. And by the time Monday got here, the case was gone. But God knew what I was going through. And he brought me on in. And I was able to give up that stuff. And now I'm a free man. Tell your neighbor, say, who the Son set free is free indeed. Whatever it might be, people, place, things, or whatever it might be, or something internal, you're just a worry, people. You're just a worry. I just worry. Whatever it might be, I want you to give it to God today. Your deliverance is for today. In the name of Jesus. Some people have a fear, what they call test phobia. When they do good in class, but when test time comes, they get nervous. Yeah. Give that to God. Whatever the phobia might be, whatever it might be, I want you to give it to God today. Because he's able. He's able. And if you need prayer today, we're going to do a general prayer. And we're going to believe God. In the name of Jesus. Whoever that's here and you want to give something to God, just come on down toward the altar right now. That's it. Just come on down. That's it. That's it.
In the name of Jesus. To break every chain. To break every chain. to break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain,
to break every chain.
There is power.
Go ahead, y'all.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Just close your eyes and begin to lift your hands unto the Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain. Break every chain, to break every chain.
One more time, come on, y'all.
There is power,
there is power
in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Jesus,
to break every chain. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The word, repeat after me these words. So the word of God says.
The word of God says.
I want you to say it with some authority. I don't want you to close your eyes. I don't want you to look at nobody. I want you to see Jesus and see him on the cross and how he died for you. I want you to get a picture of the God bringing deliverance to you, because it was on the cross, it was at the cross that I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. Give it all to him this morning. As you get that mental picture in your mind and what God has done for you, see the blood of Jesus on the cross. He did it for you. He did it for you. He did it for you. John Bunyan in the book, John Bunyan. He wrote a book about deliverance. I can't think the full name now. Pilgrim Progress. And as he began to say what he had went through, he had a burden on his back. And when he got to the cross and he began to give God praise, that burden left from him. I want you to get that mental picture of your mind right now. As we pray for them, as those in the congregation begin to pray for them in the name of Jesus. I want you to repeat it after me. It says,
Lord Jesus,
I come to you now.
You told me
to call upon you.
And you would answer me.
And you would show me
great and mighty things.
So I bring
all my headaches, all my problems, all my situations
unto you right now.
And you told me,
to cast all my care
upon you,
for you care for me.
I give it to you now,
in the name of Jesus.
And I claim victory right now
through the word of God and what you have told me. So I am free.
Indeed.
In the name of Jesus. Go ahead and begin to start praising God. Go ahead and begin to start praising him. Go ahead and begin to start praising him. 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 Come on. Begin to start blessing him. Begin to start blessing him.
Let your power to go in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord. Jesus, I want you to tell him about salvation. Tell him about salvation. All right, Father, in Jesus' name. Touch him right now. In Jesus' name. Touch his mind. Touch his body. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father.
Thank you for this
Let your blessings in Jesus' name, God. God, I'm on this seat. Back on my knees. Put running in his feet. I thank you for bringing it back. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for bringing deliverance into his family. In the name of Jesus.
The chains of addiction, they're falling. I hear the chains falling. Oh, I hear the chains, they're falling. I hear the chains falling. Oh, release the chains, they're falling. I hear the chains falling. chains they're falling down. I hear the chains falling. Oh, I hear the chains. I hear the chains.
Come on, James. Come on, come on, pray. Come on, pray. Come on. Come on, pray. Come on, come on, come on, pray. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come
on, come on.
Yes, Lord. Come on, give God a praise. Give God a praise. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. All right, daughter, you're going to be all right. Come, give God a praise for her. God dealing with her. God dealing with her. God dealing with her. Amen. Amen.
Yes, God, hallelujah.
First Lady, is your office open? Okay. Come here, Tamika. Tamika, take out this sister. Into Sister Tucker's office. I want you to pray with her a little bit more. God is dealing with her. Pray with her, God, as you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Go ahead. That's it. Come on. Sometimes you got to take out time. Come out, especially when the Spirit of God is dealing with a person.
Yes, yes.
Come on, pray with her. God, fill her with the Holy Ghost. We didn't get the Holy Ghost overnight. Somebody came and wrestled with us, struggled with us, prayed with us. We got to do the same today. I know we all on the schedule and we hurry to get out. Amen. But God dealing with her, the Holy Spirit touched her in the name of Jesus. Ah, God. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap. Come on, give him a praise. All those that's been designated as prophets of the house, I need to pray for y'all. Y'all come now. All those have been designated prophets of the house. I got to speak to y'all. Oh, God, I thank you. Okay. And one more in there. All right. It's time. Anytime you're designated to do something, don't make no excuses. Because if God took the time to single you all out, it was for a particular reason. And I'm going to pray with you today in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I need you all to help me pray around this altar when we pray in the name of the Lord. I need you to join in with the ministers as we pray. Because you have a charge on you. And you're going to have to accept it. And you can't run away from it. I'm going to pray with y'all now. And pray that the boldness of God will stand up in you. Because whenever you call upon, God have called you to pray for people, to prophesy over the lives of people, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm going to pray for you. Anytime. Second Sundays is given over to the prophets. The minister. And some of you might have to be ministering on a Sunday morning. So get the boldness. Y'all put your arm this way in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the last day he's going to pour out his spirit upon what? Your sons and whatever. And some of y'all brothers that's running and running from y'all calling. I got sons right in this church who are running from their calling. It says sons and daughters shall do what? Huh? They're going to speak the word of God. They're going to speak. Thank God for this brother here right now. Okay, amen. Praise God. It says, sons and daughters shall prophesy. I got sons that are running from their calling. You can't run no more. Oh, God, I thank you. Y'all point your arm this way in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, hallelujah. Ministers, y'all come up. Y'all should be up here with me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, stand my hand. In Jesus' name. God, hallelujah. Praise God. Hey, oh, hasa, in the name of Jesus. Gabati mesi kanamania, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Give him glory. Give him praise. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Your power travail over this woman of God. Use her for the glory of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, to your glory. In the name of Jesus. Bless them, Lord. Like never before. Give a boldness. Boldness, Lord, to speak your word. In Jesus' name. I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father. Come on, let's give him praise in the house of God. Come on, let's give him praise. Let's give him glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Let's give God praise for this young man here. He's coming. I see you've been witnessing. Amen. Praise God. We just praise God for his presence. I think. Amen. Does anybody want to be saved? He'll just stand up where you are in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. I believe our evening services is going. We're going to have to change the time from 2 to 3 because we've been getting out a little late. So I'll say we start our service at 3, give you time to go eat your chicken and get back here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Bless you. Tell your neighbor, say, bless you. I want y'all to give God a praise one more time. In the name of Jesus, we got the victory. I said, we got the victory. Stand on your feet and clap it for the victory. In the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Sister, hold it a minute. Sister Anderson, stand right there in that line with your grandbaby. Stand right there. God has endowed you with a lot of gifts, and you're running away from it. Daughter, I want you, as best as you can, to try to make every prayer night in this church. I want you to put forth an effort. Because when God is doing something special with you, and if you ever give it over totally unto him, I see souls even coming into this kingdom by groves just through your testimony. In the name of Jesus. So press your way, daughter. Press your way. In the name of Jesus. Somebody clap your hands in the temple. Somebody give God a praise. Lift those hands high to the Lord. And tell God thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Tell God thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Set the words of my mouth.
Let the words of my mouth.
Meditation of my heart. Be acceptable in thy sight.
Oh Lord,
my strength,
my redeemer,
in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
God bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
On the hill, on the cross.
God bless you, my brother. Y'all greet each other. Y'all want another service.
Amen.
Amen. Bless your daughter. Good to see you.
On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me.
All right, amen.
On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's a blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there is blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's his blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's his blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's his blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's his blood for me. On the hill there's a cross, on the cross there's his blood for me.